connect the same. You've been feeling way better on offense, feeling like yourself finally. The team is getting healthier. What can you say about the ceiling of the team going forward?
I don't think we have a ceiling. I say it all the time. We just need to become elite with the small nuances of the game. Like tonight, late game situation, we can't just give away 20-point leads like that, because in the playoffs, you know, if that's where we're trying to go, we won't make it, or that'll cost us a game, and every game matters.
You've spoken about how it'd be important for the team to advance in the in-season tournament standings. Last night, you guys secured the top spot in the group in advance. And just when did you learn about the team advancing, and like, what was the general vibe around that? Like, okay, now you are going to Sacramento.
I watched the game. I watched it. I wanted to make sure Dallas did what they needed to. So when we secured the spot, it was, all right, that's one step. Now we got to take the next step. And like I said, we got to go out there, compete, and we got to get better at the small nuances before that game happens.
Speaking of Dallas, did you have a conversation with Luka? Send him a text, say thank you, something like that?
Nah, a player like that, I don't got to text him. He's just going to do what he do.
For sure. Also, you and Herb were, I guess, in the horns action, and he was able to kind of, you know, play off you, you play off him, and kind of get some easy buckets. Talk about the relationship between you and him on the offensive end.
I always talk highly about Herb. Man, he's vocal. He's always talking. So when Coach JB said that we was going to go small ball and he was going to put Herb, like, into action, I didn't worry about it. Herb didn't worry about it. It was just, all right, let's execute. And, I mean, we did.
When was the last time you played in an elimination game?
Man, that's hurtful. it was at Duke. You lost to a weak Michigan. I'm sorry. Nah, they were. That was a great Michigan State team. I remember they came out the game gunning. Transition threes. I remember Cassius. We took a 9-point lead, and I mean, he did what, you know, vet leaders do. He took the game over, but he did it like at his own tempo.
What's just the excitement level to be in that do or die environment Monday?
I think I live for stuff like that. Because in those moments, it's one of those, it ain't no tomorrow. We got to figure this out right now. And I think that's when you see the best come out of people.
How good was it to have CJ back in there tonight?
And it was great to have him back out there. I might have told him like 5 to 6 times before the game started, hey, man, it's good to have you back out here. I mean, CJ's been a great vet to me since he came to the team. And, you know, whenever he's out there on the court, he's always dropping little gems on me to, on certain scenarios, how to make certain reads. And, I mean, that's my brother.
J.J. Redick on his podcast mentioned shooting begets shooting. So, he got CJ back tonight, had hot. But Trey Murphy and Matt Ryan also on the way back. Just what's it going to do to the offense and the team just having those levels of shooters with that command, that kind of attention?
I think it's definitely going to create more space, especially for me, B, and C. But at the end of the day, we got to continue to build that chemistry. You know, Trey hasn't – has he even played? He hasn't played this year, has he? Nah. Trey hasn't played this year. Matt has missed, like, the past week, 2 weeks. So a lot of it is just team chemistry, those guys figuring out their minutes and stuff. But I feel like once we get those things down, we're going to be all right.
We thought when the game ended, you were the first player in franchise history to go 11 for 11 from the floor. Did you, and then they changed it. Did you see the play where they changed it to a block shot by Bamba? And were you shooting? Do you remember if you were shooting on that play?
Which play?
It was at the start of the fourth quarter, right? Right before Nick Nurse got the attack.
It looked like your hand was going up like this from about 9 feet away, and the ball kind of
Oh, man, yeah. I think I was just shocked because I thought it was a foul. But, yeah, I know which play you're talking about. Man, they charged that to the game? I tell you, that one to the chin. That's tough. No problem. You guys have a great night.